I'm Aaron Baker, and you're in the GSM Nation at youtube.com/GSM Nation. And today, we're talking about the HTC One in the full video review. How does this thing compare to other Android devices, say the Galaxy S4, the Galaxy Note 3, and the LG G2? We'll find out in the full video review. The HTC One is the Android handset to beat right now. It's the powerhouse all around, and it's got some incredible specifications, including a 1.7 gigahertz quad-core Snapdragon 600 CPU, a 4.7-inch 1080p HD display, a 4-ultra-pixel camera on the back with 1080p HD video recording capabilities. HTC claims their ultra-pixel technology lets in more light than competing devices, a 2,300 milliamp hour non-removable battery, 2 gigabytes of RAM, 32 gigabytes of internal storage, and Android 4.1, or depending on your version, 4.2 on the international version and on the Verizon Wireless version, Jelly Bean with HTC Sense version 5. But the real winner here, the real eye catcher, the beautiful metal build quality on this device. Now, it's available in multiple colors depending on your region: silver, black, red, and blue in select markets. And it's a gorgeous device all around. It's a beautiful metal build here on the sides. You've got your micro SIM card slot on the left spine. Right spine houses your volume rockers, you can see right here. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack up top, along with your power button, which doubles up as an IR blaster to be able to watch TV and do all those things that you do with an IR blaster. Micro USB charging port down at the bottom, and boom sound speakers on the front here, so you can listen to your music and make it unfiltered. Let's take a look at the software. It's powered by Android 4.2, like I said, with HTC Sense version 5. And you can see right here, this device is powerful all around with little to no lag. Very quick, very zippy, no lag whatsoever. And you can see the power of Android 4.1 running on this particular device, 4.2 again on the international version and Verizon Wireless versions. But still very fast, no lag whatsoever. We talked about Android in the previous days, 2 to 3 years ago, and we saw some lag depending on what version of Android it was running and the specifications. You don't see it at all on the HTC One. Very fast all around. And this is HTC Blink Feed, one of the new features of the HTC One, which allows you to bring in what's most important to you: Facebook, Twitter, and more, along with some news feeds, and personalize this device and help you get the information that's most important to you. Blink Feed's a way where you can turn on your device and very quickly and easily access your Facebook feed, your Twitter feed, perhaps your favorite news or tech news, and go right through here and access it all in the span of about 30 seconds and turn the device back off. It's great for when you're waiting for a cab, or you're waiting to get into the bus, or perhaps getting on the train. You want to take a quick look at what's going on in your world, but you don't have time to do much beyond that. Blink Feed is fantastic. Other great things include HTC Zoe capability via the camera. This has a 4-ultra-pixel camera, like I said. You've got the device here. We'll bring over the LG G2 just for comparison purposes. And you can take a combination of pictures and then, of course, Zoe's as well, which are 3-second video snippets, and I'll show you how those perform. You turn on right here, HTC Zoe. You can see it pop up in the bottom of the screen. Press the camera button and it'll record a 3-second video. Now, at a glance, this may not seem like much. You can see right here, video running, and we'll run another one just to be on the safe side. But this is great for perhaps a wedding or when you're visiting with a friend. It's saving the photos right there, and you've got a day full of pictures and videos just now. And you can see exactly how it works. Now, the way that's implemented, we'll go in here into gallery and take a look at our events, which are comprised over the course of one day. My photos, camera shots, and more. So I can go into my photos. I can organize these by events. I can see the pictures I took today, combination of Zoe highlights and still pictures as well. And all I have to do is click up here, and this phone makes its own video for me that I can send and share with friends. So a great little 30-second clip. I don't have to do anything on this device. It does it all on its own. Very impressive all around. Jumping back into software, HTC Sense user interface is completely redesigned from the ground up with a lot of unique features. You can see that it's different. Down at the bottom here, you've got your 4 shortcuts as usual, but your app drawer looks completely different here with different fonts, icons, and more, not to mention a clock and the weather up in the top that stays up there regardless of what you do. Now, you've got a couple of different customization options. You can change the grid size from 3x4 to 4x5. I can come up here and manage my applications as well. And I can organize these applications by alphabetical order, most recent, or custom as well, which is how they come out of the box, in custom folders such as Google, as you can see here. Completely different all around. You can see even the settings area is different, the notifications bar is different, again with a different font, and the option to personalize both the wallpaper, the lock screen style, along with your typical ringtone things as well. Now, taking a look at the keyboard here, this has a 4.7-inch HD display. It's a 1080p HD display, very beautiful all around. Colors look great, and you can just see by my test, very quick and easy to type on this device. Quadrant Standard performs exceptionally well on this phone as well, reaching high odds against other devices. Very fast in comparison to the Galaxy S4, the LG G2, and some of the other competitors in the space. This is a great device all around. It's available at the 4 nationwide carriers in the US and very, very speedy all around. Definitely worth taking a look at. Keep it locked on GSM Nation. We're on Facebook at facebook.com/GSM Nation, Twitter, twitter.com/GSM Nation, and more. Thanks for watching. More to come in the GSM Nation. I'll see you next time.